I'm Sabrina Shadesai. I'm an oculoplastic surgeon and I practice at Harley Street and director of Perfect Eyes Limited. And I'm also a co-founder of the Oculofacial Aesthetic Academy where I teach cadaver anatomy. And I'm really proud and privileged to be associated with Tixil, and I'm a key opinion leader for Tixil. So Tixil is a really innovative machine or device that uses TMA technology, which is thermomechanical action technology. So pure natural heat to stimulate collagen and new collagen formation. And it gives an effect of a CO2 laser on the skin, but without the downtime or the side effects of CO2 laser. And I found it a very interesting device to treat my patients, particularly in the periorbital area where they have a lot of loose, crepey skin, thinning skin issues. And the CO2 laser can be particularly painful with a lot of associated downtime and risk of post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation. So that's one of the reasons why I chose Tixil. So Tixil has been extensively studied and it's been published, and the evidence level is really strong. Not only is it an extremely simple device to use, it has two hand pieces, the periorbital one and the full face one. They use titanium pyramids that auto-sterilize at the temperature that the machine requires to go up to, which is 400 degrees Celsius. So it's an extremely safe, clean device to use in the clinic. So it has a very good safety profile that has been extensively studied histologically on pig's skin and compared to CO2 laser. So in the studies, CO2 laser has been used for resurfacing the skin and tightening the skin, and also improving the skin texture and tone by removing solar lentigenes. And in the comparative studies, they found that Tixil is equally effective, but it requires a course, as would CO2 laser, and it requires a maintenance therapy. So typically you would have a course of between 3 and 5 for the ablative mode, and you require to have, you know, these treatments every 6 weeks when the skin is healed, and then you need a maintenance therapy perhaps annually to come back in and have another treatment. So not dissimilar to what patients who expect rejuvenation from CO2 laser to undergo. Oh, so one of my first cases that I used Tixil on, which is what made me go ahead and buy the machine, was this lady that I had done a lower lid blepharoplasty on, and she was a smoker, and she presented back a few years later with extremely loose, crepey skin in the under eyelid area. No eye bag, which is what I had operated her for, but she just developed wrinkling of the skin that was quite extensive. And I treated her with a Tixil. She had an amazing result to just one Tixil treatment, and at 2 weeks had a significant skin tightening and was delighted with the result. And that personally, as a surgeon and as an evidence-based surgeon, I was delighted to see these kind of results with, you know, no real adverse event. And that's what motivated me to buy the Tixil. Oh, completely. It's been so worth my investment. You know, I can't begin to explain what it's done for the footfall in my clinic, for my patient satisfaction, and improving the outcomes of not only my surgical cases, but even my non-surgical cases. So what I loved about the Tixil machine, as opposed to just the ablative mode, is it has an interesting meso mode. So it allows transdermal delivery of drugs and medications into the skin. And I have had amazing results for the darker skin types, which are really difficult to treat. You can't use the CO2 laser on these patients without the risk of post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation, which is quite high. And I find the meso mode with some products that we use are excellent for brightening the skin, improving the texture of the skin. So it's not just the ablative mode that I find really interesting, but I find the meso mode very effective to treat the Fitzpatrick 4, 5s and 6s.